Hey, this is Alina George, and a big shout out to my favorite magazine, The Vibe. I move around a lot because I'm never in one place for very long, so I'm everywhere. I like crashing waves, but I want to see them. It's just an opportunity to share more songs with people and to grow as an artist, to show that we've grown as artists, musicians. The difference is really in the music. I mean, we write differently every time we write a song, so we've continued to do that in the second album. So, but you know, we still have our sound that we. I don't know, that is, we come to naturally. I mean, it's just a very natural thing, I think, for musicians to collaborate and for one musician to do a remix of another. And we add our own music as well, so. It's just a, you just make things, you make things, you put it out, see what happens. Sometimes if you have a real connection with that artist and there is something in the song that's strong enough to stay strong, well, I just said that twice. If there's something in the song that holds together when it's being passed around to different people, then that makes it more successful. And we meet a lot of people at festivals. That's like where everyone is feeling very creative and very sociable, and you're out and you're all together in the backstage area. So it's a really good place to meet people. I have a very sort of scheduled time before a show. I do a sound check, and then I do vocal warm-ups, I do physical warm-ups, and then do all the makeup and hair and styling. And then just before stage, I have a group hug with all the band. And I know for now, I'm not a follower. I don't take things as they can if they bring me down. Well, we asked DJ Snake to do the remix of You Know You Like It back in 2013, and he did it really quickly. It was a very relaxed, fun thing, and it didn't really get popular until he decided to release it as a proper song later on. He was playing it in his DJ set, and his fans really enjoyed it. So that's why he decided to release it. Coachella is very supportive, I think, of up and coming bands. They're really interested in new stuff. So that's how we first played at Coachella. And this time around, I was really surprised because I would think that you would have to wait longer to play the same festival twice, but yeah, it was a huge opportunity to play the Sahara tent with all those people. So we had to work really hard to try and bring the performance up, you know, to the right standard for that. The idea of the video was to really just keep it simple and show girls just being in control in the way I mean in the song, which is not to, they're not trying to control other people, they're just trying to feel confident and be in control of themselves and their environment and how people treat them. And I wanted to show how beautiful that is if a woman feels confident and in control. I remember you said when I just woke up and I'm on your chest. I remember the sound of your heart racing when you do bad things to me. I wanna feel like it's the first night. I wanna meet you for the first time. I'm definitely, I think the first thing I'm gonna do is work with my stylist on some ideas of the types of clothes that we would like to have, like in our daily life, and then take it further from there. Next is really to do something a little bit different for the next tour we do. We're supporting Sia and Miguel on a tour, and I'm always looking for ways to be a little bit more adventurous with the live show. We like to keep it really very real, and we have real drummer and keyboard player and things. But because we have some songs that are R&B and some songs that are EDM and some songs that are somewhere in between, I feel like there's more possibilities that I haven't explored yet.